The City of Angels is home to competitive eater L.A. Beast, and he's a stomach-stuffing force to be reckoned with. The YouTube star regularly puts his stomach and full body to the test, and in turn, he's amassed a legion of devoted fans. Prepare yourself for the eating phenomenon that is L.A. Beast.
Please, do not try anything I do at home.
If you take a look at L.A. Beast's YouTube channel, you'll see him eating and drinking absurdly obscure products and mind-boggling quantities of food fit for Godzilla. That's what most people know him for. However, if you look closely at the video titles, you'll notice some that have nothing to do with food at all. But that doesn't mean he puts his body through any less stress in them. In one video, L.A. Beast journeys into the Amazon jungle to visit the Sitare Mawe tribe and engage in their brutal ritual where the tribal boys become men. It involves wearing two woven gloves filled with bullet ants, a species of ant whose sting feels like a bullet hit you, and dancing to ceremonial songs with tribal elders. Dressed in indigenous garb, L.A. Beast slips on the gloves and begins to dance. He's in agony shortly after and begins profusely sweating.
Shit, pain. At first doesn't seem that bad. It gets worse, and it's getting worse.
When it finally ends after several minutes, he thinks he's going into shock and gets carted off to the local hospital for assistance. He survives, of course, but he goes through absolute hell. In another video, much less extreme, he wears drunk goggles and hilariously attempts to make his way through a ridiculous obstacle course that results in, as you can expect, disaster. This time, however, the pain and discomfort are lighthearted and fun. It's easy to crank out videos in the comfort of a living room where there's no live audience to impress and editing software is at your disposal. That's why things got really interesting for L.A. Beast when he was offered a spot at the Comedy Palace, a venue in San Diego known for stand-up comedy. He took his voracious act to the stage to perform in front of an invigorated crowd ready to see the action up close and personal. Fans of the YouTuber fill the house as L.A. Beast walks on stage with his soon-to-be-devoured meal: raw shelled eggs, a stick of butter, whole hot dogs, a bottle of syrup, a can of dog food, a raw bull testicle, two habanero peppers, blue milk, and a small cactus. His fans arrived for a show, though, and he was ready to go full beast mode. The mixture of different textures and unsettling flavors definitely throws him for a loop. Some of them go down smooth, like the syrup and eggs, but others, like the whole hot dogs and raw testicles, send him into several gagging frenzies. The crowd never stops cheering him on, and after he wraps things up with the cactus, he leaves the stage a champion. That look on his face, however, makes it pretty clear he's happy it's over. Competitive eating challenges have no time for those who are selective about what they pack their bellies to the brim with. That's why L.A. Beast hangs with the best of them. When you step foot on his culinary gridiron, there's no opponent you shy away from, and that includes foods so spicy, even Lucifer would cower in fear. L.A. Beast welcomes those intestinal fires no matter what price he'll have to pay. Ever heard of the Carolina Reaper? It's one of the hottest peppers on the planet, but since L.A. Beast's eating prowess is out of this world, he goes all in during a Carolina Reaper eating competition at an outdoor festival in New Jersey. He eats 14 of them in under 1 minute. Picture a stomach full of molten lava and a mouth that feels like you sucked on a red-hot furnace. That about sums up what he felt like afterward. In another act of sheer insanity, he attempts 2 packs of the world's hottest ramen combined with a dollop of the world's spiciest sauce, Mad Dog 367 No. 9 Plutonium, which clocks in at 9 million Scoville units. The pain in his face is tangible, and the beads of sweat on his face are visible. But then again, if he didn't fight through so much pain, he wouldn't carry the L.A. Beast name proudly.
Never get. That just brought me right down to size right there. That was a piss-poor effort on my part.
Even though L.A. Beast seems like he can plow through anything presented to him, he's only human. Well, sort of. Sometimes viewers want to see the indestructible show a vulnerable side, and even though the semi-truck of a man looks as though he's impervious to failure, he lets fans in on his shortcomings as well. Take a look at his attempt to down 96 shots of eggnog. In a Christmas video special, the Beast arranges a massive tray of plastic shot glasses teeming with that thick and sweet drink that rolls around every December. As with any challenge, he starts out fiercely tossing the shots back like they're water. But at about the halfway point, his stomach realizes it's in over its head. Our beast not only quits, but he festively pukes all over the miniature Christmas tree next to him. Now that's how you celebrate a holiday. Another big loss came when he tried to chow down on the largest sushi roll ever created. You might think sushi is relatively light on the stomach when you order from your local sushi spot. This guy, however, plops a 15-pound roll consisting of multiple types of fish onto a plate with hopes of stretching his gut to the max.
Why? Because I'm hungry.
He gets almost halfway through, though, before the bad idea hits him like a cement truck. The lesson here? Maybe it's best not to eat sushi by the pound. A human digestive system isn't built to withstand a tsunami of saturated fat, sugar, and salt attacking it in droves. Clearly, LA Beast has a cast-iron digestive tract by now, but one challenge he takes on is a whole different animal, one with the ability to draw blood. The beast dares to consume several full cacti, complete with the spines attached. You're probably wondering how a human throat could handle hundreds of prickly bits tumbling down its walls. Well, LA Beast wants to find out, so he buys 10 potted cacti and puts his esophageal concerns on hold. But before he tackles the plants, he eats 4 dry ghost peppers. Because why not mix crazy with even crazier? The beast literally rips into the first cactus as if he's eating a steak. The spikes don't even seem to faze him, as he just chews each mouthful up and gulps it quickly down before chomping off another massive chunk. How he actually polishes off all 10 without serious injury is a mystery his fans may not ever know the answer to. YouTube, like any website that allows the public to upload videos and post written material, does its best to patrol their landscape and age restrict, or in extreme cases, completely ban overly inappropriate material. LA Beast found himself in hot water at one point when a video he had posted 7 years earlier suddenly resurfaced in a bizarre way. Before the beast amassed the online following he has today, he posted a video where he chugged a decades-old bottle of the forgotten 90s soda Crystal Pepsi. The video unfolds just like all his other ones. He chats with the camera as he drinks it, and after he's finished, it promptly comes back up the way it went down. No big deal, right? That's happened dozens of times on his channel. However, when YouTube star PewDiePie referenced that specific video in one of his own videos, YouTube took notice and didn't like what they saw. They sent LA Beast a message stating the content of the video wasn't suitable for all ages and slammed an age restriction on it, which demonetizes the whole thing. Of course, there wasn't much he could do about it, but he expressed his frustration about the ever-growing inconsistencies regarding some of the site's policies.
My video was reported, it was flagged, and now I'm
As consumers of all things trendy and desirable, everyone knows that products come and go. If an idea can't entice the masses quickly, it's kicked to the curb so the next great thing can try its luck. Crystal Pepsi was exactly that. Who wouldn't want to drink clear Pepsi? Well, it turned out most people didn't, until LA Beast came around. He knew if he wanted to achieve something as epic as bringing a deceased product back from its grave, he needed social media. In 2015, he started a trending Bring Back Crystal Pepsi hashtag on Twitter, filmed YouTube videos, and even physically ventured out to get signatures on a petition he drew up. He was serious about this, and so were his fans. Amazingly, it eventually caught the attention of Pepsi. The corporation sent LA Beast a letter thanking him for getting people so stoked in the product again. Although the message didn't give a clear answer about relaunching the soda, it did say, "We definitely hear you and your followers, and we think you'll all be happy with what's in store." Luckily for Crystal Pepsi fans, the drink has been re-released numerous times since 2015.
I grew up in a Pepsi household, and I will continue to be a loyal Pepsi fan for the rest of my life.
Tom Green was one of the founders of the I'm Gonna Do Crazy Stuff in Public and Film It era. His MTV show, The Tom Green Show, was candid and ridiculous, but after the show ended, he pretty much fizzled off everyone's radar. Years later, he actually hosted a low-budget talk show called Tom Green's House Tonight, and it just so happens LA Beast was given the chance to take the guest couch on an episode. Naturally, Beast is there to dazzle the cameras and crowd with his appetite. On the menu are raw shelled eggs, full hot dogs, an egg so rotten it's jet black, a raw cactus with the spine standing tall, and, well, a raw bull's testicle. Tom Green watches in horror as the Goliath conquers each dish. The crowd is as fascinated as they are disturbed by his ability to tear into these things like they're just honey barbecue wings from Buffalo Wild Wings. Not one to disappoint, the man chokes everything down without too much trouble. Though the rotten egg was pretty rough. It's the sort of thing that makes you wonder if Tom Green regrets getting back into television. It takes a certain kind of mentality to willingly put oneself in harm's way just because it offers a temporary thrill. Frankly, the people who attempt the kinds of challenges L.A. Beast does may even have a couple of screws loose. But in no way does that mean they aren't great people with big hearts who want to bring joy to fans. Sometimes it's those who perform the wildest antics who have the biggest sense of empathy. The Beast is certainly one of those guys, and he proved it on video. Remember the ice bucket challenge that took over the internet in 2014? Thousands of people dumped buckets of freezing ice water over their heads to raise awareness for ALS, a neurodegenerative disease. L.A. Beast wanted to join in the good cause, so he took the icy plunge and showered himself with the frigid liquid. But he wasn't done yet. After he dried off, he took another plunge, this time out of an airplane thousands of feet in the air. He went skydiving to put the good cause cherry on the cake. He loved every second of the tandem free fall, and once the chute finally opened, he told the camera that he thought he had just, well, relieved himself in his pants. Classic L.A. Beast, ending his video on a messy note.
Glad I could help raise awareness for ALS, and I think I'm never doing that again.
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more mashed videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.